And the chart-topping 80s band Eurogliders. Well, Grace Knight and Bernie Lynch were the creative force behind the superstar group. Now, in this exclusive interview with Craig Bennett, Grace reflects on her fabulous career and opens up about her incredibly difficult childhood pain.
Out in the wild west of Perth, many a brilliant musical talent has been born. The great Johnny Young, the Farris brothers from INXS, and it was the birthplace of one of our country's biggest bands of the 80s, the Eurogliders. Their hit songs, Heaven and We Will Together, climbed the charts all over the world. And for the lead singer, Grace Knight, it has been a wild and outrageous four decades of making fabulous music.
42 years, I can't believe it. My mum said I couldn't hold a job down.
Is that what she said?
Yes, yes, she said.
She was wrong, wasn't she?
She was, and I'm... No one is more surprised than me that that's the case. I've had one job for 42 years.
Incredible.
Yep.
Such was the fame of Grace and the Eurogliders, she still can't escape those big hits, even when making a simple trip to the supermarket.
What's it like, Grace, when maybe you've swanned up to the meat counter of a supermarket?
Well, as I do.
And over the tannoy comes maybe one of your famous Eurogliders songs.
This one time in Melbourne, I heard a woman at the meat counter just as I was standing beside her. Heaven must be there. And she's looking through the steak or whatever. And I was just laughing. And for the first time ever, I actually wanted to just go, well, it's just got to be there. And I just wanted to sing with her. And I felt too embarrassed. I didn't have the courage to do it. I thought she might have turned around and said, go away.
The key figures of Eurogliders are Grace and her ex-husband Bernie Lynch. Despite divorcing in the 80s, they continued touring together and recording songs. The breakup of their relationship happened during the making of that famous and raunchy film clip for We Will Together, a clip that led them being banned in America.
Still together when we were storyboarding it and deciding what this video should be saying, and then we split up before we came to film it, and so I'm like and so is he, by the way. But it was a love song, and we'd already decided we were going to have all these kind of love scenes, and it'd already been paid for.
You'd made all the costumes.
I've made some of the costumes.
Not that there were many wore.
Yeah, but Bernie had moved on and he had a new partner.
He didn't.
Yeah, didn't. He's not one to hang around, our Bern. So his new girlfriend, I remember, was standing in the doorway while we were filming this love scene. And Bernie was lying on top of me and kissing me, and I'm thinking, oh, f***. But while he's doing this and she's standing over there, I just like, nah, this isn't working for me. I wanted to be a bit more powerful. I didn't want him on top of me. I wanted to kind of like, I'm moving on too, you know. And during the filming of this video, I flipped Bernie over and I lay on top of him. And then I felt like, I can breathe now. Video clip gets finished, it gets sent off to America, they won't play it.
MTV won't play it.
Because why?
Not because it was too risque or anything, because I was lying on top.
What?
Yes. If he lay on top of me, they were fine with that, but because I was lying on top of him, it was like, oh, we're not doing that in America.
Did Eurogliders make you rich?
No, Eurogliders did not make me rich.
Well, I read somewhere that you were paid like $300 a week.
Yeah, 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 for maybe 10 years we were paid. Yeah, well, it's a very expensive business to get into, you know, when you've got lights, smoke machines, crew, guitar roadies.
Not a lot left over.
There's not a lot of money left over.
Although on the outside it seemed like Grace had it all, fame, a fabulous career, but few knew she was hiding a dark pain. She'd been sexually abused by her father.
Part and parcel of the effects of being abused is really, you know, this worthlessness and self-doubt and kind of bashing yourself up. There's a lot of that. But it wasn't until I was in my 50s that I realized whatever had happened to me as a five-year-old was over the next day. You know, whenever it happened, it was gone the next day. But here I am, 50 years later, I've allowed my feelings of, you know, lack of self-worth, I've allowed that to shape and define who I am. And so I've actually done more damage to me than my father ever did. And that took me such a long time to work that out. I mean, I tried to get professional help, and it just wasn't working. I needed to kind of stumble on it myself. It was a revelation to me that I was the one that was nurturing these awful thoughts and these awful feelings. It was me that was nurturing them. My father had forgotten anything he'd ever done.
Well, he was an alcoholic too, wasn't
he? Well, exactly. He might have just chosen to forget it, or he might not have known. I don't know, because I never confronted him about it.
With extraordinary strength and resilience, Grace found the courage to not only come face to face with her father after so many years, but to actually forgive him for the horrors he'd committed.
I forgave him because I was put in a situation where my son wanted to meet his grandpa. You know, no matter what I feel, it's his right, that's my son's right, to know who his grandpa is. And he really wanted it, so I was like, you know, I've got to get over myself because I need to do this for him. And so I took him off to meet his grandfather, who lived in Greece and who was also very, very ill. But when I saw my father with my son, and of course my son didn't really know anything about what had happened, I saw this really beautiful relationship. I could see the sort of father that I never had, but I could see the capability of my father towards my son. What happened when I forgave my father was life-changing. I thought I was a decent person, and I wasn't all the things that I had labelled myself as. I was a good person, and I was, you know, quite a caring and compassionate person. He was more than just an abuser.
Grace has found a new love and passion for music, performing jazz classics around the country. And she still gets a huge thrill from touring with the Eurogliders and singing those original, unforgettable hits.
It's really hard for your heart not to burst out of your body when you hear all these people in front of you singing. I mean, how can you not be moved by an audience bombarding you with their joy and their kind of feeling and their attachment to those songs? I'm really moved, you know, sort of 20 years, more so than when they were hit singles.
Interview. And Grace Knight has a brand new album out called Grace, and she's currently touring with her own show, as well as, of course, with Eurogliders. And you can head to gracenight.com.au. Details there on your screen for all the information.